What's the best that humans can hope for? Where's the furthest that our society can get to? In the modern world, we're forever striving for the future, picturing what tomorrow's world might look like, and imagining the infinite power that might await us there. But actually, are we inescapably limited as to what we can achieve? Because does all of this, all of life, the universe, and everything, really exist under the ardent gaze of something else? This is Unveiled, and today we're answering the extraordinary question, did scientists already discover a Type 4 civilization? Do you need the big questions answered? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one, and ring the bell for more thought-provoking content. The Kardashev Scale stands as one of the leading models for future potential, ranking hypothesized future groups or civilizations based on the amount of energy that they can harness. We have Type 1 with all the energy of its planet, Type 2 with all the energy of its star system, and Type 3 with the energy of its galaxy. On the original scale, as developed by the Soviet astronomer Nikolai Kardashev in the 1960s, that was the upper limit. But in the years since, even higher levels have been added. Most notably, Type 4, with the energy potential of the universe, and Type 5, with the potential of the multiverse. All the ramifications of a multiverse are for another day in another video. But with Type 4, we are at least still dealing with a physical structure that we can recognize. The universe is hardly new news for anyone alive today, whereas those of the not-so-distant past found themselves debating exactly how space was structured. We now have the concept of the universe, as most popularly modeled by the Big Bang Theory, to guide all of our studies and predictions. The universe is seemingly everything, to the point that science finds itself unable to truly define its shape or size. We have the observable and unobservable parts of it, yes, but the idea that anything could exist outside of the universe is, well, a headache. At the topmost level of Kardashev Type 4, however, you arguably still don't need to step outside of the universe just yet. You need only to have total and unbreakable control over every single thing, thought, or concept that's inside it, including yourself, every living thing, every object, every particle, and every dimension that's possible within it, from space to time and beyond. Ultimately, it's as simple as that. But really, there's nothing simple, easy, or even particularly comprehensible about what a Type 4 being would be capable of. And while by some understandings of the Kardashev Scale, even these heady heights aren't technically out of reach for the human race, that is, we should theoretically be able to achieve Type 4 if we just move through the lower levels first of all. Precious few would confidently claim that that's truly the case. Unless humans can become effective gods, unless we can change ourselves beyond all recognition, Type 4 is probably impossible for us. But that still doesn't necessarily mean that it's impossible for all. If we accept that there could be other civilizations out there, and that the chances are that many, probably most, are more advanced than we are, then to another group, Type 4 might not be so difficult to imagine. And all we can do is to try to connect with such a group. There was a time when just the realization that different planets existed represented a sea of change for scientific thought. But now we're dialing down into the very fabric of reality and trying to find some kind of life force for everything. For some, that force, that mystical something that makes everything possible, could well be tied up with dark matter and dark energy. Indeed, the discovery that 95% of the mass energy of the universe is actually unknown to us is arguably the greatest signifier yet that we know nothing. But does the existence or our detection of dark matter and energy automatically mean that there is a higher power out there? It depends on whether anything has ever been able to get a grip on it. Because if, say, a millions-of-year-old alien race can control dark matter like we control ordinary matter, then yes, there certainly are higher powers out there. And yes, science might have already discovered a Type 4 civilization, just without really realizing it yet. Dark matter and energy aren't our only potential signs, though. While dark energy is often presented as the unknowable force that's accelerating the expansion of our universe, there are theories that actually, that particular physical setup could be merely a local arrangement. One much-debated reading of the wider Big Bang Theory is that the original moment of creation might have actually spawned many, infinite even, bubbles of existence. These bubbles, of which our universe is only one, then exist on a higher dimensional plane, in a kind of superspace that's also expanding at a phenomenal speed. According to this model, it's as though, if you zoom out far enough, even the entire universe would look like just a marble rolling or falling through the void. Now, this idea in itself also perhaps doesn't prove that higher, universally powered civilizations exist, but consider any being or group that could provide evidence of the infinite bubble theory. To us, it's little more than a trippy thought experiment from our lowly point of view. But again, if there are other civilizations out there, and if any of them are more advanced than we are, which is likely, and even if just one of them can view our universe from such a lofty perspective, then they are Type 4, at least. The pale blue dot is arguably the greatest and most important photograph that humanity has ever produced, because it, more than anything, forced us to look at reality differently. To understand that our world, our planet, is actually tiny, no matter how all-encompassing it feels and is to all of our lives. The image was captured by the Voyager 1 space probe in 1990, at a time when it was more than 3.5 billion miles away from us. Since then, the Voyagers have traveled further still, and we've thrown technology all over the solar system and visited all the planets and many of the major moons. With telescopes like the Hubble, the Chandra X-ray Observatory, and the James Webb, we're also taking better-than-ever pictures of the galaxies and star systems that surround us. And perhaps more than at any time previous, humanity is feeling pretty accomplished when it comes to space exploration. But now imagine having a view of reality like ours, only instead of stars, planets, and star systems, you're cataloging universes. Consider all that we've achieved regarding space in the last century, then double it, treble it, or multiply it by 10. Automatically, you soon surge up the Kardashev scale. The first image released by the James Webb Telescope, the deep field of thousands of galaxies, was described by NASA as showing the equivalent portion of sky as that covered were you to hold a grain of sand up from your face at arm's length. In the span of that grain, there are countless billions of other worlds. We can see them, but still only just. And there are more beyond even that, which even Webb can't pick out. Imagine then that same image, but 100 years more advanced, or 1,000. How much more would it reveal? That's the kind of vantage point that a Type 4 civilization might have. But what's exciting, or fairly terrifying, is that one such group could potentially exist within the Webb Deep Field itself. There are so many galaxies captured within that image, hosting so many unknowable worlds, that if you again accept that alien life must exist, and you follow the Kardashev model, then it's arguably likely that we are now seeing them with our own eyes. It's just, again, we may not necessarily realize it. From here, and with the Webb busily scanning the rest of the sky for us, it's a sure bet that astronomers will be keeping a keen eye out for potential evidence of things like Dyson spheres or Shkadov thrusters. Clear technological proof that something cleverer than us is out there. But it might not be so long before the search takes on an even greater sense of existential importance. We're seeing the universe like never before, so is it finally being revealed to us how the whole thing really works? How long before we breach the edge of the universe to truly investigate the infinite bubble theory, or before we reset our filters so that they become sensitive enough to chart dark matter? It can feel as though the growing library of web images is pushing us toward the next great breakthrough. And maybe it is. After all, when we look at the universe now, the detail is like never before. And so, while scientists haven't confirmed a Type 4 civilization yet, just as they haven't confirmed any form of alien life yet, we might now, or soon, be seeing what's really hiding in the rest of space. We might have even already photographed it. It's just that we're waiting to decipher the data. What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments, check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.